Hey guys, this is my first ever second chance review video. I don't know how many of these I'd be doing, but this is the first one. This is a review of some different mermaid blankets from DressLily. There's going to be a link in the description for each of these blankets, and I'm going to do an unbagging and review on these blankets. I had ordered a mermaid blanket from them before, and I was not happy with the original one I got. I thought the tail was quite small, it was not what I wanted, and I made a video and the video wasn't too favorable. However, their customer service is absolutely amazing. I think I added a notation to that video that their customer service was excellent. They responded to me. I didn't actually write to them and complain, I just made a video and I left like a not horrible, but not great review on their actual page. They saw and they got back to me right away and helped me out. And so now I've got a stack of 5 blankets here to review for you guys. And I would say definitely I will recommend them based on their customer service. And the blankets are very well made. Well, the one I have is anyway. So we will open these and see how they are. I got some light on, so we'll start first. I've got this beautiful blue that's similar to the one I have, but I can tell by the weight of it that it is indeed different. I haven't opened any of these yet or felt them, so we'll see what they feel like. So this one here, this looks to be a smaller tail. This looks kind of almost like a child-sized tail. I'm not sure if it is or not. It's just the washing instructions. So this is a little coarser than the other one. It's not a full body tail. It's pretty cute and little. This would be actually really good for a kid. This has got to be a kid sized one because I don't see this fitting an adult. This is a lot shorter than the one that I have. I'll try these on after this video. And then I'll add some pictures to what they actually look like, if I can fit this one on or not. If I can, then it's just a small adult one. And if I can't, then this is a child one. But the colors are beautiful. The weaving is quite tight. It's not made very cheaply. It doesn't look like it's going to fall apart or anything like that. The tail's quite the same as the other blanket that I have. And it's got this pretty blue and brown kind of earthy tones to it, different shades of blue and green and a little bit of brown in there. So that's a cute little tail. If this is an adult tail, then it would be a little bit easier to move around in than the bigger ones. But like I said, I will see when I try them on. So that's tail number one. This is tail number two. This is quite a heavy one. I think this is probably the heaviest one of the lot. So this feels very, very weighty. And the material to this is very similar to the one I just pulled out, but a bit softer. This is a multicolored. This has got blue and red and yellow, and it looks like orange, and some kind of like a brown, a dark green. Lots and lots of different colors in it. This is a big one. This is quite big. And in the rest of the world, it's going to be coming on winter time, so these will be really good. Oh, this is interesting. Yep, this is a nice sized one here. This is the front of it, so it opens quite wide, just like a normal blanket. And I can already feel it's very, very warm. This is a nice long one. This is actually, it looks to be longer than the one that I have. And so the tail is a little bit different. The tail looks a little bit bigger as well than the one that I had gotten. So that's the fin. Nice rainbow color. The fin is a decent size on this one. Narrow area for your feet. And again, you can't see through it. It's very tightly knitted, crocheted, whatever it is. Very warm just from having that on my lap. And the colors in this one are pretty striking. In the bag, it didn't look like it was anything spectacular, but taking it out of the bag, laying it here, it's actually really beautiful and really, really, really weighty. This has got some good weight to it. This one I'm quite interested in. This has got 3D looking scales on it. Very interested in this pink one. And this is the softest one out of all of them. This one here is very interesting looking. I hadn't seen this on the website. I hadn't seen pictures of it. This is a bit more lightweight than the one that I just pulled out, but it's still obviously, you know, a blanket. This is pretty cool because it's got fins, like scales on it. That's really, really cool. This would make a good summer blanket when you just want a little throw, but you don't want to be too warm. The tail's different, but interesting all the same. So this is what the tail looks like. This is very, very soft on the edges. And it comes out like this, and it's got this little frill at the bottom, this multicolored frill. I love, 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 love the colors of this blanket. This has got different shades of pink and yellow and blue and white. And it's a very vibrant, very, very unique. I really, really like this blanket. I love the way this looks. And this isn't tightly knitted. You can see there are gaps here so that it gives you this scale-like effect, and you can't lift them up. I mean, they're knitted together, knitted very, very well, but it gives you that total 3D look to it, which is really nice. And yeah, this here will let you breathe a little bit so it's not too hot, and the top is like the tops of all of them. You can pull that up to your shoulders, but again, I'll have pictures of that coming up so you can see what these look like. This is also a long one. This one here was from the same model as the one that I got. So this is the same blanket, but a different color. This is actually the other color that I was interested in. And I wasn't sure which one to get, and I had chosen a blue one because I thought, oh, blue, water, ocean, fish. But this one in person reminds me of candy. Really, really pretty. This is new thing I'm doing where I like light colors. I don't know what's wrong with me. So this opens like a normal blanket. You've got a little bit of space here to breathe as well. This is probably the second heaviest after the first heavy one. And again, it'll be because it's got these holes here so that you can breathe and you can feel some air on you. The colors of this are very interesting because it's got this blend of every color. It's mostly white, but then you've got your green, your yellow, your purple, your red, your blue, and that's just really, really nice. This is also pretty soft. The softest one is so far is the pink one. The tail opens out, and it's a normal fin, so it opens out like that. A little bit smaller than the really heavy one, but still hasn't, you know, with the tail spread out, it's got a nice rainbow kind of stripey look to it. This is good for anybody that likes rainbows and colors and stuff. So you can see the mermaid shape there. I think this will be pretty interesting to try on. This is, it is kind of weighty. It's already making my legs warm just having it on my legs, even though it's got, you know, spaces. This is still nice and warm. Now it's the one I'm the most interested in, which is this one here, the last one. This, I have no idea how this goes. This is actually just about as weighty as the weighty one that I pulled out a couple of blankets ago, my second one. So I'm eager to see what this one looks like. So this is, yeah, this is pretty heavy. This is another really warm, wintry one. They're all about the same degree of softness. The very first one was a little bit coarser than the rest, but that doesn't mean that it's hard at all by any means. It's not hard, it's just harder than these other ones. So this one is wider than the other ones. This isn't as narrow, this is quite a wide one, and pretty long. This looks a lot bigger. This is another big one. The fin of this one is quite small, just simple purple. But it looks like it's closed, which is really good. So you put your feet in there and it's actually closed. It won't open so that your feet are exposed. Like some of these tails, you would put your feet into them and it's open so that you can walk. See, like this one, you put your foot in and your feet are there so you can actually kind of hobble along. And this one, which I think is really cool because I like things that cover my feet because I get really cold. I don't see any way here for your feet to come out. So it's completely sealed up, which is really good. Your feet will stay nice and toasty in this. You will not be able to walk, but who needs to walk, right? Just get your, you know, get somebody to do your work for you. The colors of this one are pretty unique again. They're really good with the colors. The colors are really vibrant. No loose threads, no fraying threads, which is really good because that's what I look for when I buy something, is if it's got threads sticking out that shows shoddy sewing or whatever. You know, you guys know what I mean. You get dresses or toys and it's got the threads sticking out of it, like it hasn't been connected fully, but these are all really nice. I don't know how well you can see the colors here. Like this looks like it's just all green and blue, but it's not. Inside here, see, this is got a thread of blue, orange, yellow, and green. And this one's got purple, yellow, red, orange, and green. So each area's got four different colors in each of these little sections. So that's pretty cool, if you can see that. Each of these little things has got four threads, and each thread is a different color. And that gives it a really unique rainbow look to it. And so this is probably my favorite one because of the fact that it's flat open, it's wide, you flip it around and you stick your feet into it. So this is the back of it. I'll show you the backs of the other ones as well while I'm at it. But you put this over your body and you stick your feet into it here, and your feet get tucked away nice and toasty here at the bottom. They don't go anywhere, and it's a nice throw, and you can flap your pretty little tail around. So that's the bottom of that one. I've shown you the bottom of this one. This one, you flip it around and it opens like this. This goes over your lap or up to your neck, and then you stick your feet in here. Let me raise up my camera a little bit. And your feet come out there so you can, you know, walk, move around. And let's see, this beautiful scale one, this is so light. This is the softest one right here. This is just like a cushy ball of just soft goodness. This is another one that's open at the tail, so you would put the throw over yourself and it makes sense because this is such a lightweight one that you'd be able to have your feet out and you would walk, well, hobble around. I don't think they're made for walking in because they are quite tight, but you know, I do walk around in them just very slowly. This big heavy one is also open, so they're all open, they're all the same. They've got the blanket that goes up to your chest, and then the tail that you have your feet sticking out of. And I know that this little one here, which now it doesn't feel as coarse. I don't know why it felt coarse when I first opened it, but it's actually not. And this is an open tail as well. So, and this is different because this, This one here does not have the top that you throw on yourself. This just has a tail that you pull up over your waist. The other ones are open here, the cut open, so it's a blanket and then it ends in a tail. This one is a complete tail all the way around. Now that I've gotten to see more of the blankets, I'm a lot more impressed because each blanket is unique. They've each got different features, they've got different patterns, they've got different colors. They're all very, very well made. They're all very unique. The quality is quite high. And to me, most importantly, the customer service is absolutely amazing. I really appreciate companies that realize that their customers are what make them, and companies that pretty much shit all over their customers and act like they don't need them. I don't want to give them my business. I don't want anything to do with them. But if a company does something wrong, or they know a customer is dissatisfied, and they do their best to talk to them, find a resolution, work it out with them, they approach the customer even, that right there puts them quite high at the top of my list. Berserk did this, and they are my favorite clothing company. DressLily has more than helped me, and so I don't mind changing my review, because I know my initial review for their blankets wasn't too favorable. But again, this one here, this shows me the diversity of the different kinds of blankets that they have. And depending on if you want something just light for summertime, if you want something heavy for the winter, you've got a complete variety here, and you pretty much can't go wrong because they're all made extremely, extremely well. They're all a good weight to them. They're all nice and soft. They're all vibrant and unique, and they'll do the job. It just depends if you want your feet covered or uncovered, if you want a throw that's going to go up to your shoulders or something that's going to fit around your waist. Kids, adults, there's something for everybody. And within each of these different designs, I know that they've got different color combinations as well. So, you know, if you liked this design but you didn't want it purple, they'll have a different color. The same with this. I know that this design comes in like this color blue, or it comes in just an all kind of green color. You know, they do make these in different color variations. Just if you're interested, the links are in the description below. You can check it out and see which ones you want or whatnot. I'm not making any money from this. This is just because I'm quite overwhelmed with their customer service, and I wanted to give them something back and make a review on their blankets. And so I don't mind speaking out for companies that deserve it. So that's what I do. If you buy something from them, there's no code or anything for me to give you to where I'd be making money off of it. If you buy it, it's because you like it. And I know quite a few of my friends and followers are big fans of mermaids, and some other people like blankets, and some people want stuff for their kids. And so hopefully this review is a lot better than the one I did last time, and it shows a bit more. So if, you know, your kids like pink, there you go. Your kids like purple, there you go. Your kids like rainbow, there you go. I've had people asking me, do they make them in pink? Yep. Do they make them in purple? Yep. Do they make them in rainbow? There you go. So now I'll have to take pictures, and I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys later. Bye. This is the first tail that I thought was a child's tail. It is not a child's tail, it is an adult tail. And laying down, this is what this one looks like, which is much better. So you pull it up, very soft, and it's open, so you're not actually sitting on the blanket, your butt's still on the whatever, and your feet get nestled in here very nicely, and there's the tiny little hole that your feet don't fit out of, which makes me wonder why it's even there in the first place. But whew, it is very warm, very, very hot. This is the warmest one out of all of them. And this is the rainbow one laying down. Very, very, very warm, even though it's got peepholes and air holes in it. It's still quite heavy. The colors look really, really nice when you've actually like got it on you. It's very pretty. I actually really like this one. This one's got a bigger bigger foot hole at the bottom, so two of your feet can stick out. But still, I wouldn't suggest walking in it because you've got a very narrow range of movement. But man, it's like candy. It's so pretty, this one. So this is the scaly one laying down, and again, it's a nice summer blanket, nice and lightweight, stuck to my thingy, really comfortable. You can't really feel it, but it's just enough to keep you warm. That's the tail, and this is so weird because it looks like they should lift up, but they don't. They're kind of like little pockets, but yeah, this is a nice summery one, perfect throw for spring, I'd say, spring or fall, or if you just want to be a prude, like me. Last blanket, second warmest blanket, open again the same, quite high at the top, covers your whole body, and no foot opening, so it's actually like a flat flap, which is pretty cool. So this one, you've got complete warmth, unlike the other ones where you might feel a breeze. So if you get cold feet like I do, or always, my feet are always freezing, this is probably the best blanket because of the fact that it's closed at the bottom, and you don't have to worry about your feet showing or whatnot. And it's split about the same, which is underneath your butt, so you can get in and out of it easily. And that's it. Hopefully I've shown these enough so you can see them standing if I use any of those videos, sitting if I use any of these videos, pictures, and everything in between. And my favorite one is probably this one because it's closed, followed by the candy one, the white one. And the other ones are pretty equal. I think the one that's at the hips is my least favorite just because I've got quite big hips and it's a bit of a squeeze for me. But if I was skinnier, I think that I would like it a lot more because it's actually more the tail that I was looking for. But these are really good because they're proper blankets, and that one obviously won't keep you warm. It's more for pictures or whatnot. But yeah, these ones are good.